Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss some more type of approximate straight line motion mechanism. With the help of these mechanism we can define some different type of approximate straight line motion. So let's start the discussion of different other types of approximate straight line motion mechanism. So first type of mechanism I have discussed, that was Watt's mechanism. Now the second type of mechanism is modified Scott-Russell mechanism. So as we know, this is the Scott-Russell mechanism, and in modified Scott-Russell mechanism, exactly what we consider if we define different link of the Scott-Russell mechanism. So this is the Scott-Russell mechanism where we consider one slider. One connecting rod. And one crank. And this slider slide with respect to fixed link. And here this OA will rotate about point O. And it will rotate in a particular direction with some angular velocity. So this OA rotate, so it will oscillate this link AP, and the slider will move in forward and backward direction. And with this particular motion of reciprocating motion of P, we will consider this point Q, which is the extension of AP. So with reciprocation of slider P or complete rotation of OA in one circle, this Q will reach position O. And again, for this particular complete rotation, this particular Q will reach Q dash. Q dash we will form somewhere here. And this QO will be equals to 2OA. And that is complete reciprocation of point P along this length OP. So this is about the Scott-Russell mechanism. Now here in Scott-Russell mechanism we consider OA equals to AP. Now in modified Scott-Russell mechanism, OA does not equals to AP. So this condition we will consider in modified Scott-Russell mechanism. So in that case, this point Q will not form exact straight line motion. Here we will consider point A. This particular point A will move along a curve, and this point A will form an elliptical trammel, or it will form one ellipse. So this will be exact modified Scott-Russell mechanism when OA is not equals to AP. So in that condition, this particular extended point will not form exact straight line motion or exact straight line. It can form approximate straight line, but this point A will move about one ellipse, or it will form ellipse. So this particular modified Scott-Russell mechanism we generally define, or we generally use to form ellipse on a particular mechanism, or to form elliptical path for a particular mechanism. So basically this modified Scott-Russell mechanism we generally use to form elliptical trammel or to form elliptical path with the help of this point A, and where major axis we will consider as AQ. And minor axis we will consider as AP. So here, with the help of major axis AQ and minor axis AP, we can define the ellipse with the help of this motion of point A with rotation of crank OA. So this is about modified Scott-Russell mechanism. And if we want to define AO length, and on the basis of AO length, we can define this major axis and minor axis. So this AO will be AP square by AQ when this point A is forming one ellipse. So this is all about modified Scott-Russell mechanism. Now, next type of mechanism is Grasshopper mechanism. So this is the diagram of Grasshopper mechanism, and this is also modified Scott-Russell mechanism. And the modification is, in Scott-Russell mechanism, we consider reciprocating motion of point P or slider P. So here let us consider this is the point P, and this point P is not reciprocating, it will moving along a slight curve. If we define reciprocating motion, so this P is moving along a straight line. But here, what modification we are doing? This point P is moving about a curve. So this point P will move with some small angular displacement, and this point P will move with small angular displacement of link OA. Here OA we are considering as a crank, AP is a connecting rod, and this point P is considered as a slider, but this slider is not moving along a straight line, this is moving along a curve. And this curve motion or curvilinear motion of point P we can define by the rotation or angular displacement of OA, that is AOA1. And this point A is moving about this point O, and it will have only a small angular displacement, and that angular displacement, if we are considering theta, this particular angle we are considering theta. So in that case, when this link OA will move in this direction, so this point P will also move in this direction about one curve, and the center of rotation for this particular point P we will consider as O1, and radius we will consider as O1P. And this O1 we can consider the point which is forming turning pair with fixed link. So this is with fixed link and it is forming a turning pair. So O1 position is not changing, but P is changing its position with respect to O1. So here, with the help of this angular displacement AOA1, this P is moving along a curve with radius O1P or with respect to center O1. Now, this is the motion of connecting rod, crank, and curvilinear motion of this slider or link P. Now, what we have done here, like Scott-Russell mechanism, if we are extending this AP up to point Q. So, in that condition, when this link OA is moving with small angular displacement, in that condition P will also move toward P dash with small angular displacement, and here point O and P is also moving with small angular displacement because this P is moving along a curve. So with small angular displacement of OP, this point Q will move in downward direction and it will form a straight line motion up to point Q dash. So here the angular displacement of OP is generally defining the approximate straight line motion of point Q toward Q dash. So this Q dash will not exact straight line motion, it will be approximate straight line motion, and this straight line motion we will define with the help of angular displacement of link OP. And here we will consider same condition like previous. Here AO will be equal to AP square divided by AQ. So AO we can define with the help of this particular formula. So this is about the Grashofer mechanism. This is another type of approximate straight line motion mechanism. Now third type of mechanism is Chebyshev mechanism. So this is the diagram of this Chebyshev mechanism. Here we are considering one link, it is fixed. So OO1 is the fixed link and other three links are AB, OA and OB. So this is a crossed four bar chain mechanism and here this O and O1 are forming a turning pair with fixed link OO1. So O and O1 is not changing its position, but with the help of this O and O1, these link will have motion. So this OA link will move with respect to point O and this OB link will move with respect to point O1. And here AB we are considering as a coupler or coupling rod. So on this AB, if we are considering point P, so point P will move along a rectilinear path or along a straight line motion and it will form approximate straight line for this particular mechanism. Here when these three condition or these three position here, A2, P2 and B2 are representing the extreme position of the link, this particular link or this particular mechanism. Similarly, A1, B1 and P1 is also representing the extreme position of the mechanism. And in this extreme position, when this point P will moving toward P2, so it will form a straight line from P to P2. And when we are considering this extreme position, this particular extreme position, so this P will move toward point P2, P1. So by this way, this point P is forming approximate straight line motion. And this is the Chebyshev mechanism where we are considering crossed four bar chain mechanism to form a straight line or approximate straight line motion with the help of point P on link AB. Now, next type of mechanism is a Roberts mechanism. So here, this is the Roberts mechanism. So here we are considering four bar chain mechanism again, where this is a fixed link. You can see here, this is representing a fixed link. And with fixed link, we are considering two points, O and O1. And this O and O1 are forming turning pair with the fixed link. And here, other links, A, O and B, O1 and AB. So, AO and O1, B are connected with the help of one coupling rod or coupler, that is AB. So, this particular diagram is representing the extreme position of mechanism and it is forming a parallelogram. This is representing a parallelogram. So, this is for the extreme position of the mechanism. And here we are considering this point P and this point P is connected with point Q1. Here you can see this point P is connected with Q1 and this point P we are considering on link AB. So here this point P is dividing AB into two equal parts. And here OA and O1B are equal in length. So this condition we are considering OA that is equals to O1B and here this AB is straight in the initial condition. Now when let us consider this OA is moving in a particular direction and this point A is rotating about point O. So in that condition the position of point A will change. So this A1 is considered as a displaced position of point A. Or let us consider this A dash. Either we can consider A1 or we can consider A dash. So let us take this point A as A1. This is the displaced position of A. When this point A displaced toward A1, in that condition, this point B will also displaced. So this is the displaced position. This B dash we are considering as a displaced position of B. So B dash is the curve and A1A is another curve which is formed by the displaced position of OA. And here, when this point A is displacing toward A1 and B is displacing toward B dash, in that condition, this P and Q position will also change. When this displacement we are considering A to A1 and B to B dash, with this displacement, this point Q will form one approximate straight line in the form of Q, Q dash. And when we are considering displacement toward B, so this particular point Q will move in this direction. So, with the angular displacement of OA in this direction, B position will change and this Q will form approximate straight line with the help of this angular displacement. So, this is about the Robert mechanism. Thank you so much.